Hello, I'm Doublestream. I am Rich. Right. It's been a while. Welcome to Broken Sword, the Smorgon Mirror. We're going to rock through. I'm going to have myself a nice, chilled one here. It's kind of quiet. And, to be fair, it's been a while since I've done anything. Basically, what's happened is... I got a promotion, as such. As a lot of you know, I'm a chef, and I got a new job recently. Here, what happened was my kind associate left, just disappeared, gone, no more. So basically, what happened was I had to take over, which sucked. I've been working 7 days a week for God knows how long, and it just kind of has taken over everything. Completely taking over everything. To celebrate our reunion, but which means I haven't been able to do this very much. An appointment with an archaeologist. Something to do with and as well as that, it means that my work, like, commitments, my schedule, along with Big Chin 2, along with the badges, has clashed really badly. So, we're pretty much looking that... it's difficult to get anything going. Hence why I'm doing this now, hence why I'm by myself, hence why it's still sunny outside, because normally we do a nighttime job. But, as I was saying anyway, long story short, or TLDR, work's fucked up, life's fucked up, games are fucked up, but we're gonna get back. So, anyway, Broken Sword 2. It's going to come off the back of my sweet-ass Broken Sword 1 playthrough, which I enjoyed. And we're going to roll with the second one. And as soon as I get this done, I'll preview the third, and the fourth, and the fifth. And the fifth's really good because I played all of it. Big-ass red and black spider. I'm going to try and keep me clicking down because, of course, this is a mouse game. And... my microphone decides it wants to pick up every single click, every single pop. And I need a good old hardback book. Even the new Warhammer rulebook. And we'll get more to come with that at some point as well. Okay. We've got party one here. And it's spider time. That spider looks a hell of a lot bigger than it did. Yeah, we'll go. I don't know if it's the remastered graphics or the old ones, but George looks like he's just earned quite a lot. There were only three things I didn't like about spiders. The way they looked, the way they moved. And if I lived on the same planet as me. This spider was big, mean, and hairy. And definitely not made of. I'm not too keen on the art style here. Shoo, spider, shoo! Alright, let's have a look. I'm going to fly through this because it's one of the best games. I so miss playing these. They don't make good ones like this anymore. That block of wood. It's a loose block of wood. Right, so I'm sure that spider was bigger than the last time I played this game. Or I played on a really small TV. Squeeze! But it was a question. Stuhlberg, you go squish now. I was still tied to a chair in a burning house with no means of escape. Metal bracket. The bookcase had been anchored to the wall by a protruding metal bracket. It had sheared off as the bookcase had fallen. I'm not keen on these heads in the corners now. I used to like where you get the old LucasArts style jibber jabber, and then you'd have the words on the screen. Ta-da! Out of the chair with a nice big smile. Now, I had to deal with that fire. Let's do this. Yellow. Let's have a look at you. I ain't touching that spider goo.
I wasn't touching that spider goo.
Alright, here we go then. Big ass dart. Sharp dart with a flight of green and yellow. I'm taking this. That dart was sharper than a mosquito's. My god, right? It's weird playing these old style games when they're remastered in high def, because that square of his head looks fucking sweet. Whereas the, what do you call it? The actual graphics of Mr. George here, the blocky as fuck. It's like I've drawn them in paint.
It was a closed drawer. The bureau had a sliding lid.
Then let us slide.
Inside, I found a bottle of tequila.
Tequila time.
Normally,
drinks on.
I drink strong spirits, but today was far from normal. Ew. Disgusting. Not only did the tequila burn like hell, I just managed to stop myself from swallowing the worm.
Ooh. I'm sure there'd be nothing worse than swallowing a worm.
Lay on the carpet. Thanks. It was only the worm from the tequila bottle. Well, I wasn't going to eat it. But life had taught me one thing. No matter how unlikely it seems, the strangest objects have their uses.
Okay, so... Tour farming. This is the first time I've played the remastered one of these as well. So we're looking pretty much the case being is...
It was Nico's bag.
That I'm now noticing all the little extra spiggy bits. It was Nico's bag. Let's go, purse snatching.
It was a stylish little canvas number containing a lipstick, a handwritten note, and a pair of nylon panties with a large love heart emblazoned across the front.
Just what you keep in your bag really for a day out to get beaten up and kidnapped.
Well, they could be useful.
As we steal our underpants. Now this has a different setup on this. Oh,
it was a pair of
look at them kecks.
Lace-trimmed panties decorated with a large black satin heart.
Sexy time.
I guess I had no business reading the note, but I figured it might give me a clue to what Nico
was done.
It was from Andre Labino, the history student Nico had known
you
in college. The letter was sent
that a dirty man
and revealed that the exotic lingerie, as he called it, was a gift from him. It gave.
Well, let's go on. Call him.
Rival for Nico's affections, but I couldn't believe that that creep was in the running.
Hey, little caterpillar dude. Lovely, lovely.
It was that itsy bitsy tequila worm. I really must remember to take it out of my pants.
Oh, imagine washing your worm.
It was the poison dart which had stunned Nico. I'd never known anything keep her quiet so effectively.
No, I'm gonna have to get myself one of those.
It was the box that spider had crawled from.
I'd rather not touch it. After that.
In the cabinet's wooden door was a very small keyhole.
That fire's looking very, pixely.
Fire had taken hold and ignited part of the polished wooden floorboards. It was a soda fountain, perfect for mixing with drinks or squirting at clowns.
Clowns. Nay.
There was no pressure in the siphon. I guess it was out of gas.
We take it? Fire then. So let's use a dart on here. Stand beside the burning flames. Open up this door. Kaboom!
As I released the lock, something blew the doors open. Inside the cabinet was a small metal object, round
it's my siphon.
With a valve at the other. The cabinet was already open.
So why is it letting us?
Small metal cylinder.
I'm taking this.
That cylinder was hot. I couldn't pick it up with my bare hands.
It's panty time.
The panties I'd found in Nico's bag were just what I needed to wrap around the hot cylinder.
Okay. There are pants for the cylinder. There's a question mark up here. I got the gas. What now? Let's go back. 5% complete already? Jesus. I haven't even gone for 10 minutes. Not even that. Let's open up the drawer. Which is probably gonna be locked.
In the drawer was a small pot.
It's a small pot. check this shit out. Contained a key. It looked like a key. To where? It's the key to these panties.
I'd better think this through.
I'm gonna get an angry face every time that I bolt something up now. Now we'll go then. Let us pop the cylinder on the siphon. So that hot gas cylinder from 30 seconds ago.
The cylinder gave out a
faint is now not as hot. Shake it, shake it, shake. Scoosh, scoosh.
Now I had one primed up and ready to use extinguisher.
So we got a really, really wee little siphon, which is probably about the same size as a bottle of pop, to put out that giant fire. Let's do this. Ta-da!
With a well-aimed squirt, it was so
loud. And we're free, and I've lost my drink.
Now it was time to start looking for Nico.
Out we go.
I was gonna burn myself on that red hot doorknob, and it wasn't the time for subtlety.
It's the only time that he's ever gonna be able to make it there. Nope, use cotton.
A folded clipping taken from a newspaper.
I'm having that. Anything I can pinchy pinchy.
Found a piece of
coming with me.
Folded in two. It referred to a forthcoming eclipse of the sun. Unfortunately, it wouldn't be visible from Europe. The best place to view the eclipse would be Mexico.
We're going to Mexico!
Much as I dislike
telephone time.
Labano might be my only hope of finding Nico.
Random gangster telephones.
Hi, Andre?
Who is this?
It's George Stoker.
Who is this?
Nico's boyfriend?
Don't you mean boyfriend?
Look, I didn't call you just to pick a fight. I need to talk to you about Nico.
Can't you accept she's just not interested in you?
These comic book ones.
We need to talk.
Those squares in the Nico's corner, it's just not nice.
Okay. You remember the cafe at Montfaucon?
Sure. Andre? You better show
you. Bastard hung up.
I felt an irrational urge to wipe my ear. The front door was made of hard wood.
Supported by a sturdy frame. Let's do this.
The door was locked. I didn't
think
they've
locked us in.
This door down.
I'll see what this door is.
The door led to some other part of Ubier's mansion.
And do I need to go this way? It's locked anyway.
It was locked.
You see, now the clever thing to do on a remaster would be to let this key open this door instead. Another puzzle.
The house key didn't fit this lock.
But obviously they decided against that. And out. Out. We go!
I unlocked the door. I wasn't looking forward to meeting Labanon again, but he was my only